Soon I will be done with the troubles of this world. Oh, my troubles of this world, troubles of this world.
Good afternoon once again, everyone. This is 287, and still, those who are keeping the Sabbath, I hope you're having a happy and blessed Sabbath today. I was doing some reading, and I was reminded of an article I came across the other day, which was extremely interesting to me because it talks about a phenomenon called sleep paralysis. Now, I'm going to say this. If I'm to believe this article, then I, among probably many of you, are probably nutcases thinking anything different. And the reason I say that is because when we disavow anything that Scripture says to replace it with what man says based on science and his investigations, we're doing exactly what the enemy wants us to do. And because we don't want to be contradictive or contrary to what the world is saying, people will go along with accepting explanations that the world gives them if we can't rationally and to the satisfaction of other individuals explain something. But I'm here to tell you, I'm going to go by the word, but I want you to know about this article because this is what many people will succumb to as opposed to what they perceive as real, which in my opinion really is real. So, the name of this article is Strange Sleep Disorder Makes People See Demons. And they put demons in parentheses as to make light of it. What the enemy wants. It's not to acknowledge that these things are real. And let me explain this once again. Let's not get caught up into thinking demons are something so foreign and evil that we don't know what they are. They're nothing more than fallen angels. Remember those angels that fell from heaven with Satan? These are those quote-unquote demons. This is what we call them here on earth, but they are fallen angels. And once again, they maintain their strength and their abilities even here on earth. They have no bodies of their own, and they can take the form of individuals, and they can possess individuals and all that, as well as our other hosts of heaven. Those angels can come here in the form of man, and the ones that are in heaven come here to do the Father's will, and they do things more ought than not to help. So let's not get and create such a divide between the fallen angels and those that are still in heaven as to not acknowledging that the evil ones do exist, and they do things. They work for the adversary himself. So let me get into this article a little bit and point out a few things that it says. It's written by some filmmaker named, her name's Carla McKinnon, and apparently she has had a bout or has bouts with these episodes of what they are calling sleep paralysis. And what it is when you're asleep. Well, I'm going to read parts of it. It says, now the research is becoming a short film and multi-platform art project exploring the strange and spooky phenomenon of sleep paralysis. This film, supported by the Wellcome Trust and set to screen at the Royal College of Arts in London, will debut in May. Okay, so this individual they're making a short film documentary about it. And from reading the article, what they're trying to do and what they're going to do is explain it in scientific, psychological terms and medical and psychological terms. And the interesting thing is, for me reading it, they can explain what's happening to you, but there's nothing in this article that explains what causes it, and there's nothing to solidify how to end it. I'll tell you what causes it and ends it: demons. And what ends it is being on the right foundation, this right spiritual foundation. Remember, scripture speaks a lot about demons and how to rebuke them. So, let's go to this. It says, sleep paralysis happens when people become conscious while their muscles remain in an ultra-relaxed state that prevents them from acting out in dreams. Now, the Father designed our bodies so that when we sleep, our bodies go into this relaxed state so that we don't act out in our dreams. Now, why would the Father create us to go into this state, but then all of a sudden, so many people, according to this article, 5 to 60% of the population suffer from this sleep paralysis disorder more often than not? It's not real. So it says the experience is quite terrifying, with many people hallucinating a malevolent presence nearby or even an attacker suffocating them. Survey puts the number of sleep paralysis sufferers between 5 to 60%, like I just said. I was getting quite a lot of sleep paralysis over the summer quite frequently, and I became quite interested in what was happening, what medically or scientifically it was all about, McKinnon said. So this lady, she wanted to find out what was happening medically or scientifically. Now, those of you in the Word, when things like this happen to you, the first thing you do is acknowledge that something evil and malevolent is happening to you. And we know where this comes from, because if you're in the Word, you already know. You don't go, I want to find out what scientifically and medically is happening to me. We know what's happening. Her questions led her to talk with psychologists and scientists. Man's desire to have to explain it medically or scientifically, or something is not right with it, or something is not wrong with it, however you want to view it. If we can't explain it through science or psychologists, then it's all in our mind. It doesn't exist, so to speak. So it reads, myths and legends about sleep paralysis persist all over the globe. From the incubus and succubus, male and female demons. There are no male and female demons. Demons are asexual. They are non-sexual beings. The Father created them. They are non-sexual beings. Think about this. There's enough going on with humans, male and females. And you think the Father would create and have this same kind of chaos in His heavenly kingdom? They are non-sexual beings. But they don't even acknowledge that they're demons or fallen angels, so this is what they are. One man told about his experience. He said he experienced extremely realistic hallucinations of a young child skipping around the bed and singing nursery rhymes. Sometimes the child would sit on his pillow and talk to him. One night, the tot asked the man a personal question. When he refused to answer, the child transformed into a horrendous demon. Well, let me say this. If you're asleep or in a sleep paralysis state and you see something running around your room and you know it's not a real child or a real person, you already know it's a demon. So for it to become a horrendous demon should make no difference. For another man who had the sleep disorder, this gentleman was a narcoleptic, and this says that it can make sleep paralysis more common. He would hear voices and banging around in his sleep, but he would be awake. And a lot of times when this happens, you're in an awakened state, maybe not so heightened, but you're in an awakened state and you know you're awake. And it says one night he awoke in a paralyzed state and saw a figure in his room. Now, to his horror, this other figure in his room was a real individual that was robbing his home while he was in a paralyzed state. So that made it even more so unnerving. Now, and then it goes on, it talks about myths and the science. It says, sleep paralysis experiences are almost certainly behind the myths of the incubus and succubus, demons thought to have sex with unsuspecting humans in their sleep. The science of sleep paralysis explains these myths. The science explains these myths. See, no one in articles like this are going to say scripture explains these quote-unquote myths. The science of sleep paralysis explains these myths. The science of suffocating or someone pushing down on your chest often occurs during sleep paralysis. Have you ever had that happen? That pressure on your chest, you can't move, you can't breathe, you try and scream and nothing comes out? I'm telling you, demons. When they become conscious while still in a breathing pattern, people try to bring their breathing under control voluntarily, leading to the feeling of suffocating, really. Here we go with science explaining everything, but yet they're not explaining what causes it or how to prevent it. So is it really an explanation? They're just telling you what's going on. Add to that the hallucinations that seem to seep in from the dream world. They're just seeping in from the dream world. And it's no surprise that interpretations lend themselves to demons, ghosts, or even alien abduction. Now, they say perhaps because when you've been traveling, you're too hot or too cold, or you're sleeping in an unfamiliar or spooky place. Well, most people aren't traveling or aren't too hot or too cold or aren't in an unfamiliar spooky place. This happens to most people in their own beds, in their own homes when they're asleep. Those tendencies may make it more likely that a person will experience sleep paralysis when already vulnerable to thoughts of ghosts and ghouls. The trick, she said, is to use episodes like a form of research, paying close attention to details like how her hands feel and what position she's in. The sort of mindfulness tends to make scary hallucinations blink away, she said. Rationalizing is incredibly counterintuitive, she said. It took me a really long time to stop believing that it was real because it feels so incredibly real. Just what the enemy wants for us to continue in every way, shape, and form to acknowledge he doesn't exist. We do it in stuff like this. And there are plenty of people that will read this and go, oh, that's what happened to me. It was sleep paralysis. And plenty of these people who aren't in the world are going to read more and more articles like this and give no credit to the enemy and his helpers as to what they do to us. These demons, they get on you, especially in your sleep. But like I always say about demons, we have to understand we create pathways and doorways through things we do or don't do in our lives that allow them to come in. If you are living under the will of the Father, if we're putting on that coat that he talks about to protect ourselves from the enemy, he can't get to us. But if we're out here doing all sorts of things, opening up all these pathways into our lives, the enemy can come in and wreak chaos in our lives. And that's just one thing, this quote-unquote sleep paralysis disorder. I like to call it the enemy trying to take us in our sleep, because that is his ultimate goal, to take us away in our sins, to destroy us in our sins. If he can do that, we will not enter into the kingdom. So remember this sort of thing when you read or hear about articles like this. This stuff is foolish, you know, but if the people who believe this were to hear me, they'll say that I'm a nutcase. So be it. I'm a nutcase. But I tell you what, I'm going to go by the word. The word explains everything about demons way better than man does in all of his articles and scientific and psychological explanations. Anyway, with that being said, this is 2Base7. I'm out.